Hey, do you want a chance to win a free college t-shirt? Here's what you have to do. Subscribe to the Crimson Education YouTube channel, comment what your dream school is, why you want to go there, and what t-shirt you want. All right, let's get the video started. Hey everyone, I'm Shreyas. I'm a second year graduate student studying planetary sciences here at Caltech, and I'm studying the chemistry and physics of planetary and pre-planetary systems. Yeah, so I'm studying for my PhD in planetary sciences. And what that means is we basically study planets inside and outside the solar system. So what's going on with them? What are they made of? What do they look like? How can we better understand where they came from? Things like that. And my specific research right now is focused mostly on extrasolar planets, planets outside of our solar system. And I'm really interested in figuring out what they're made of, kind of what are they like? How big are they? How massive are they? What are their compositions? And also kind of why they're that way. Like, what are the specific physical and chemical processes that made them that way? Yeah, so I got interested in this kind of research as an undergraduate. I was studying astrophysics and computer science at Columbia University in New York City. But before I kind of decided on my majors, I was really kind of indecisive about what path I was going to take because there were so many aspects of science that were interesting to me. I was super into like chemistry, physics, like the whole thing, right? And something that I really love about planetary science is that it brings together all of these disciplines and you can sort of draw from knowledge in each of these areas and kind of turn them into some new knowledge. And I think that's really beautiful. So structurally, the PhD program is kind of a 5 or more year situation where in the first 2-ish years, you're kind of working towards your master's degree. The first year is a bit distinct, so you're taking a lot of classes, but you're also working on 2 separate research projects that are supposed to be orthogonal to each other in content, which is, of course, challenging, but it's a challenge that we all sign up for enthusiastically. And then we have our qualifying exam at the beginning of the second year, and then we finish our classes, and then from there on, it's just research. In addition to our requirements for taking classes and researching, one of the other things that we have to do is to TA classes. And you don't have to do it your first year, but every year after that, you're required to TA at least 1 class. And so last term was my first time TAing here. I TA'd the planetary physics course actually in this classroom. And that was super, super fun to do. Mixed undergrad grad class and learning about the physics of orbital dynamics and how planetary systems interact, how planets in planetary systems interact with one another. Yeah, so right now we're at the Turtle Pond at Caltech, one of my favorite spots on campus. If I need a break or something, I'll just walk over here and like sit on a bench and, you know, just think, or I'll bring a paper and read it, or, you know, any other number of things. It's just a relaxing spot on campus, and the turtles are always fun to see around. So there was definitely a big adjustment from being an undergraduate in New York City, you know, all the big buildings and stuff, to coming out here to California and, you know, totally different climate, totally different things that I'm working on. It definitely was really different. Probably the largest thing that I had to focus on was learning how to manage my time more effectively, to be quite honest, because, you know, as an undergraduate, you have a lot of agency over what you do, but you also have obligations to like, you know, 5, 6, 7 classes that you're taking every term. And so it becomes a little challenging to, you know, schedule time to do other things. Whereas here in grad school, that problem grows exponentially because not only in your first year are you taking classes, but you're also you're heavily involved in research projects. And then on top of that, you might be TAing some term, and it's a lot to sort of juggle and balance, but one tries to find a way. Yeah, so the fellowship that I recently was awarded is called the Paul and Daisy Soros Fellowship for New Americans. And what it entails is kind of encapsulated within the name, I think. So it's a fellowship for new Americans. It's meant to celebrate and support the development of new Americans, whether that is immigrants or children of immigrants or refugees or what have you, and to further support their contributions to the American society. And it's been really a cool experience to be awarded this really prestigious fellowship and to meet all the people with all their incredible stories during the interviews. What it comes with is I'll be flying to New York in October for the PD Soros Fellowship Conference, where I'll meet all the other fellows and we'll discuss basically what it means to be a new American and how that's influenced our work. And additionally, it comes with a financial kickback that's, you know, always really nice. But I think kind of the primary thing that I'm going to take away from this fellowship is the community of people. I was really, really humbled when I was reading sort of the announcement for the fellowship and looking at all the other folks that were awarded it, just reading their stories, and it really was a lot to take in, and it's a lot to live up to, but I think I'm ready for it. Yeah, so right now we're sitting in front of the Hamitman Center, which is the newest building here on campus. It's a student center, so lots of things happening here, from student performances and practice rooms to the Red Door coffee shop and the Caltech store, where you can buy things like this. Yeah, it's a great place. I think the most surprising thing about studying here has just been that there's always something really cool happening, like on campus. Like, people are working on really insane, incredible things here. So there's always an opportunity to learn, and I think that's really something that makes this place quite incredible. So the application process for me was I submitted all the sort of statistics, like my transcript, my GRE score, my subject GRE score, although that's becoming less and less required by programs as time goes on, which I think is a good thing. Additionally, you have to get recommendations from your teachers or mentors. Maybe three is what you're looking for. It's kind of a sweet spot. And additionally, you have to write essays. So what I wrote about in my essays was basically how I envisioned myself fitting into the research culture at Caltech, and specifically talking about the different professors that I'd be interested in working with, and why their research was interesting to me, and how experience that I had gotten in undergrad would help me fit in and transition nicely to a graduate career here. And I think that the essays are a really, really big part of your application, and demonstrating that you're able to fit in to the research culture is a vital part of your application. I think something that I wish I had thought more about, and that I learned to think about when I got here, was kind of the human aspect of doing a PhD. You know, you don't think about it as much when you're applying to programs. All you're really focused on is, oh, is this place a good fit for me academically? Do they have the right research stuff? But I mean, remember that this is gonna be like 5+ years of your life, right? You're gonna be going somewhere and spending time there, a lot of time there. And it's important that you choose a place where you like the people that you work with, and you like the environment, and you feel comfortable in that space. Because again, it's a large part of your life that you're dedicating to this endeavor. So if you like this video and want to learn more about top colleges, make sure to like and subscribe.